Welcome to Education Lifeline. Today, we'll be solving problems on parallel and perpendicular lines. Now, if you haven't watched our previous video on parallel and perpendicular lines, then it'll be linked in the description below, as well as on the top right-hand corner of your screen. Please check that video out before watching this one. So here we have three problems, and the first one says, find a line parallel to y equals 5x minus 3 and passes through the point 3, negative 1. So we're asked to find a line that is parallel to a given equation. So parallel means that the line will have the same slope of the equation. So the slope of this equation is 5, since it is in slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. So we know the slope, and we know a point that the line passes through. And when we know the slope and point of a line, then we can write it in point-slope form, which is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So if we plug in, then we'll get y minus negative 1, or y plus 1, equals the slope, or 5, and then x minus 3. And that would be the line parallel to y equals 5x minus 3, and that passes through the point 3, negative 1. Now, if this equation asked us to find the slope-intercept of the line parallel to y equals 5x minus 3 and passes through the point 3, negative 1, then we could solve that in two different ways. We could start by doing this step and then changing point slope form into slope intercept form. So if we do that, we would have to distribute the 5. So y plus 1 equals 5x minus 15. And then we can subtract 1 from both sides to get y equals 5x minus 16. Or we could start with y equals mx plus b and then plug in all the values we know. So we know that m is 5 and that y equals negative 1 when x equals 3. We can find b, so that gives us negative 1 equals 15 plus b, and if you subtract negative 15, you'll be left with b equals negative 16. And when you put 5 for m and negative 16 for b, you would get y equals 5x minus 16, which is exactly what we got right over here. Now the next problem says, find a line perpendicular to negative x plus 2y equals 2 and passes through 1, negative 2. So here we're finding a line perpendicular. And perpendicular means that the lines have opposite reciprocal slopes. So in order to do that, we have this equation right here, and it's easier to find the slope when it is in standard form. So we can convert this to standard form. We can add x to both sides to get y on one side. So that would be 2y equals 2 plus x, or x plus 2, since mx is before b in slope-intercept form. And then we can divide both sides by 2, each term by 2, to get y equals x divided by 2, or 1 half x, since it's 1x divided by 2, and then plus 1. And that would be the equation in slope-intercept form. So in the original equation, the slope is 1 half. So to find a line perpendicular, we need to find the opposite reciprocal slope. So The opposite of positive is negative, and the reciprocal of 1 half is 2 over 1. So the slope is negative 2 over 1, or just negative 2. So now we have the slope and a point, so we can write the equation in point-slope form. So that would be y plus 2 equals the slope, or negative 2, times x minus 1, when we follow this right here. Now again, if we were asked to find it in slope-intercept form, then we could either convert this right here into slope-intercept form, or we could start off with y equals mx plus b, plug in everything we know, so the slope is negative 2, x is 1, and y is negative 2, and we can find b. So we have negative 2, negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, plus b equals negative 2. Add 2 to both sides to get 0 equals b. So our final equation in slope-intercept form would be y equals negative 2x plus 0, or y equals negative 2x. Now the last problem asks, are the following lines parallel, perpendicular, or neither? So one of the equations is in slope-intercept form, so we can identify the slope easily, which is what we need to find to figure out if the lines are parallel, perpendicular, or neither. So the slope here is 1/3. Now let's convert this next equation into slope-intercept form so we can find the slope easily. So we can subtract 3 from both sides, 3x from both sides, and that leaves us with y on the left-hand side equals 7 minus 3x, or negative 3x plus 7. And that would be our slope in slope-intercept, or that would be our equation in slope-intercept form. So now we can see that the slope is negative 3. So we have a slope of 1/3 and a slope of negative 3. Now these aren't the same slopes, so it cannot be parallel. And the opposite reciprocal of 1/3 would be positive's opposite is negative, and then 1/3 reciprocal would be 3 over 1, or negative 3. So the lines are perpendicular. If this video was helpful, please drop a like and subscribe to Education Lifeline. Be sure to watch our previous videos and check the description below for other helpful resources. Thanks for watching.